I'm Dr. Rosana Moraru, ophthalmological surgeon in Oculus Eye Clinic in Bucharest, Romania. I am also medical director of the clinic. I'm currently using femtosecond laser technology with Zimmer Z8 LDV femto machine. And I use it in the last 1.5 years. I used to use another platform beginning with 2013, but now we changed in the last 1.5 years to this machine, Zimmer Z8. I found some interesting advantages of this femto machine. First of all, it is, I think it is the most versatile femto laser machine. It is, from let's say ergonomic point of view, has a lot of advantages. It is a small finger footprint, and it is on wheels. You can change its place in the OR when you need it or when you don't need it in the OR. It also doesn't require special environment conditions, let's say special temperature or humidity or other things like the other platforms, the femto laser machines needed. So I think from this point of view, it's very advantageous. From the surgical point of view, we found that Z8 brought a lot of advantages as well. First of all, it has three modules inside, so you can use it for several procedures, not only for cataract. You can use it also for LASIK flaps, for so refractive corneal refractive surgery. You can use it for corneal transplants, both perforating transplants and dark, deep anterolamellar keratoplasties. And we also, you can also use it for intracorneal ring segments. Having all these facilities, all these possibilities, we found it more attractive from, let's say, economical point of view, because as we know, it is an expensive technology. But in this case, it is more, we can say that it is more convenient, because we can perform more surgeries with several types of surgeries for several types of pathologies for several patients. In terms of energy, this machine also brings a huge step forward. We are talking about low laser energy with nanojoules with high frequency. What does it mean? This type of energy means that the energy delivered in the eye is very small. Thus, it will not produce releasing of the prostaglandins or other inflammation mediators. Thus, will lead to no meiosis during the femto procedure, no rise of the IOP during the femto procedures, so a lot of positive things. On the other hand, the spots, which are not only of a certain diameter, but is also they are also overlapping, ensures a precise and resistant cut in the capsulotomy. Moreover, the energy released by the laser is in such a manner released that is in the corneal cuts, it doesn't kill the cells, let's say, so you won't have any important apoptosis of the cells, so the cut will be very smooth of the flap, corneal flap, for example, in refractive procedures. Since we already have the femto machine in our OR, of course we intend to use it as much as possible. So we use it not only for cataract surgeries, and we recommend it for mostly all types of cataracts, including easy cases, standard cases, or more complicated cases. But we also use it in corneal transplants, and we perform penetrating keratoplasties, especially the two special designs, the top hat and mushroom design, which are very important in some of the cases. So we recommend this type of a certain design for some specific cases, let's say. We also perform deep anterior lamellar keratoplasties, and it is quite helpful, especially for the surgeons which are in their, learning curve in this technology, in this technique, a bigger bubble technique. And we are looking forward to see maybe in the DSEC cases if we can use it in preparing our graft. And lately we had the chance to use it for a few patients, but there are still other patients on the pipeline, let's say. We use it for some patients with keratoconus, which are not yet suitable for corneal transplant, but they are very suitable for intracorneal ring segments. And we did this in a few patients lately. And we are quite happy also with this surgery.